What the fuck happened there? Something hit. Fuck me. Whew. Holy shit, I didn't think I was getting that up. Whew. That's failure, baby. Whew. Oh. Oh. Oh, baby love. Oh. What a pump. Holy shit. Oh, you motherfucker. Holy. Fuck. Forgot to tighten that. Oh, fuck me. Oh, shit happens. What the fuck is going on? Fucking shoulder. Fuck. Oh.
Whew.
Baby, pump is insane. So right now, I don't know how much we have on there. It's over 200 pounds, I know that. So I'll get 5, and then I'll take off a 10 on each side. And we'll go for failure. So it's like a drop set. Or a back off set. Whatever you want to fucking call it. All these stupid new terms. Keep it simple. Oh. You know what? We'll just take off this. I just got on the peg on the right. My shoulder, for some reason, is not fucking cooperating today. But the work is getting done. On to dips. Holy shit. Last set of 3 sets of 10 bodyweight dips. Holy fucking moly. Oh yeah, baby. Whew. Sweet talking Jesus. I had it a little wider. The stretch was fucking nuts. Whew. On to banded crossovers. So during COVID, we didn't have crossovers or flies or anything. We ended up using a lot of bands. So This is what we did. Surprisingly enough, these are 30 to 40 pound bands, and the contraction, I feel it more on bands than I actually do on kibble crossovers. It takes a lot of the strain off of the shoulder as it's coming up, but the contraction at the bottom is fucking insane, and I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Three sets of 20, 15 to 20. Short rest, short rest. The only thing you got to worry about is them exploding from the friction, but they're cheap. Holy fuck me, man. Whoa. Fuck. What a fucking pump. Again, short rest. Get that blood in there after all the heavy work. Get in the blood. You want that blood in the chest. Get all the nutrients from the blood into the muscle. Fucking love this shit. Love this shit. You gotta be fucking mental at 52 to keep doing this shit, but that's what makes us fucking strong, makes us fucking different, makes us stronger in life in general, because we strive for punishment, if that's the word you could use. Like, nothing can stop us. 40 years of this shit, and nothing can stop me at anything I wanna do. Anything. Because we have that mentality of work ethic, because we come in by ourselves into a gym to punish our bodies every day. Not many people do that. Keep killing it, guys. Keep grinding. Don't be a pussy of the world. Keep grinding. And we're still working too. You know, 10, 12 hour jobs. Working at home. Working for your kids. Everything. We never stop because we're fucking real men. Real men never stop. We are built for punishment. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Whew. Woo. For some cool down, today we're going to do some speed bag and some double-ended bag work. And we're using the fucking peanut. I haven't used it in a long time, so patience is going to be very important in this. Like, size of my hand. It's very small. Size of a softball. I can't believe it. I actually did pretty good. I kind of blew my mind there. I usually do about 10 rounds of 1 minute on, 30 seconds off. I do that basically for everything. But today, short on time, I'm fucking starving. I haven't had breakfast yet, and it's going on 9 o'clock. I've been up since 5 o'clock this morning. So, yeah. Let's do another round here. That's what I'm talking about, bitch. That's what I'm talking about, bitch. Motherfucker. Take a sip of water. Finding the groove on that one. Shoulders are on fire after benching, crossovers, dips. Whew. Holy fuck, you want blood in the shoulders. Okay, let's go. Oh, fuck me. Woo! All right. Double-ended bag is a little harder, trickier for me, because I don't have much room. As you can see, I have this wood, I have a bag, but it makes it for close fighting, right? So I practice mostly my jabs and stuff, little uppercuts, stepping in, you know, taking it nice and easy, and then eventually the speed goes up. Always moving the feet, you know, walking in, bang, 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 little short uppercuts, bang, bang, jabs here and there. Then eventually the power comes in. Always moving the feet, just like in a fight. So basically, this is like a close quarter fight for me because of the bag to my right. And then the wood bag's taking over. So you just come in closer, light taps. Bang, 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 bang. So just imagine doing this after bench pressing, incline bench pressing, cable crossovers, dips. I've been doing this for over 2 minutes now. Shoulders are on fire. So again, just because you're 52 years old or whatever, doesn't mean you can't have fun and enjoy boxing, kickboxing, MMA, or just training in general, doing fucking bag work, CrossFit, bodybuilding, powerlifting. Age doesn't mean nothing. It's about learning to listening about your body, how it's feeling. Obviously, today my bench wasn't that great. My shoulder wasn't working, but we got it done. A little bit lighter than what I was hoping for on the bench, but it is what it is. We got to keep moving. The moment you stop moving, your body's going to shut down and it's just going to reject everything. Everything you worked so hard for. That's what I don't understand about bodybuilders, professional bodybuilders, or strongmen, or anybody that has done a sport for so long. Then they decide to quit completely. Why would you quit a sport that you say you love? If you really love a sport, you will do it for the rest of your life. It might not be as good as what you used to be, but you will be fucking 100 times better than anybody at your age. So why would you quit? Why would you give up? Like, you see so many bodybuilders. Listen, I get you're on huge amounts of drugs, but it doesn't mean you have to stop doing the workouts and just get fat and fucking ugly. It makes no fucking sense to me. Same with strongmen and boxers and MMA fighters. You see some of them, they just look like a bag of shit. Why would you do that to yourself after all the hard work that you say you love the sport? It baffles my mind. I'll never quit. I'll fucking die doing all this. I'd rather die doing what I love. Age means nothing. And people that use age is the weak. Like, how can this not be fun? Listening to music in the garage, hitting a bag that you're thinking about somebody's face, a boss, a co-worker, or, you know, just even a loved one. For some days, you just want to punch them in the face, like a brother, a sister, you know? Just coming in here and letting some steam off. How can that be hard? It's just awesome to be able to do something, either in hockey, boxing, MMA, rugby, you know? Just listen to music, you know? Boom, 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 boom. Bam, 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 bam. See, it's easy. And it builds your hand-eye coordination. You're keeping your mind focused. Bam. Listen, guys, I just want to tell you all that thank you for all the subscribers. It's been growing really fast. I love it. It's just an old guy showing that age doesn't mean nothing. And for you young guys that are watching, thanks, man. You guys can learn a lot from us older guys and maybe get your father back into training or your mom. Anybody. It's about being healthy, a lifestyle, you know, just having fun. Boom, boom, boom. You know, just enjoying life so that when anything does happen, Boom. You're ready. You're ready physically, mentally, spiritually. Nothing can stop you guys, man. Exercise is a beautiful thing. Even walking, putting on the headphones, going out for a walk. So anyhow, I just wanted to thank you all for subscribing, liking, sharing, whatever you guys do. I don't know. I'm just an old fuck that's just having fun in the gym, having fun hitting the bags again, doing MMA, kickboxing, whenever I feel like it, whatever I'm feeling that day. And I'm just putting it out there for you guys to have some fun and hopefully inspire you guys to keep training. Look at 52, man. I used to weigh 290 at my prime when I was doing strongman and powerlifting. And now I'm down to 235, sometimes 228. It all depends on how many carbs I'm taking that day. But, yeah, guys, age means nothing, man. Trust me. Been doing this for 40 years. Love you all.